Keselowski's car has climbed to 12, probably running a little more to his liking. And Kyle Busch has marched to the front. Might be stalled here at 6, but he battled Clint Boyer, could not pass it. Now leads Truex and Elliott.
Like I think right now, it's 89 laps. I think everybody's just hanging on. Trying to, you know, get to the end of this stage, get some fresh tires, make some adjustments, go ahead and get
it. I certainly know Truex is. You can just see the way that he's not able to do much to prevent any of these passes there to come, and he just almost let them go by. He's just saying, please, give me tires.
Like the fast lap when we started this race, 22:58. Right now, last time by, guess what we ran? 25 flat. So we're just about stopped.
Well, for Kyle Busch, mission accomplished. To come from 32nd to 7th. When they pit at lap 100 and the caution comes out to end stage 1, he's going to be a top 10 car, and I call that a win from where he started. Definitely a win.
I just can't believe the pace right now, how slow we're going.
Well, now here's Steve Denhouse. He's about to get his other lap back from Joey Logano.
Yeah, he's not going to have to worry about the free pass, so he will be back on the lead lap, and we're less than 10 laps to go before the end of stage 1.
And Larry, don't you think this awesome computer software and programs that these teams have, they're telling them and helping them with their pit strategy. Something must have told that 17 team, hey, we want to stay on the lead lap. This is what we need to do.
Yeah, because he's used his stuff up, but he still has much fresher tires by pitting at lap 58 than these drivers that's been out there for 92 laps.
One thing I kind of learned the hard way a couple of times, second guess of those guys down there in the pits, the crew chiefs, they know a little bit more than we do, seems like.
Austin Dillon in the top 10. His teammate Ryan Newman one spot back as they battle for stage points here. 7 laps from now will be the end of stage 1. Vince.
You know, with the number of sets of tires that these teams have, it breaks down to about one set for every 40 laps. We've run more than 90 laps in this first stage on tires that they used during qualifying. So it's no surprise that everyone is screaming because of handling, and for the most part, it's because of the tires. So keep an eye out. We have another long green flag stretch in stage 2. We're going to see a similar plan possibly to what we're seeing right now. Who's fast on the long run? That could be a different thing tonight.
I'm sure anyone expected we would fire on from the opening green flag with 100 straight laps of green flag racing, but that's what's happening here. 5 to go in stage 1.
Yeah, and do you think Joey Logano looks in the mirror and says, is that the 10
car closing on me?
Because Almirola is closing fast.
All right, Logano putting Daniel Hemric, the Chapless, North Carolina young man, making his Cup debut at Richard Porter's number 8. Eric Almirola to the outside over Wallace.
What I like about what I'm seeing out of Almirola, besides he just has a fast car, he's able to run a different line than a lot of other cars, so he's not getting held up in traffic as much as Logano is.
What I see, Jeff, is he's getting off the corner really, really well. Everybody else seems like they're pedaling their car a little bit. He can just manage to come off the grid.
Now right in the middle of the racetrack, too.
4 to go in stage 1. Well, to put a period in a Stenhouse story, when he pitted, he was 18. And on the lead lap, he's going to end this stage, it looks like, in 16 or 15 on the lead lap.
I think that was a game. I know it was a very little game, but I think the risk of him going a lap down was very high.
The only way it worked, it had to stay green.
Yeah, exactly right.
All right, pit road is closed as we're in the final two laps of stage 1. Now it's Kevin Harvick.